Now we can go to the fourth problem, where we see that temperature has been given, T is equal to 170 degree centigrade and H is equal to 2821.5. So here we had P and entropy, here we have T and H. Again the approach is remain the same. Here P was given, now we got T. So I will go to table number 1 and get the value of HF and HG and compare with given value of H and come to the answer. So now we have understood many things. Just get the value of HF and HG and compare them with the value of H at temperature equal to 170 degree centigrade. Can we see table number 1? But before that, let us come to the calculations. So question number 4, T is equal to 170 degree centigrade and H is equal to 2821.5 kilojoule per kg. We know that temperature is less than T critical. So we are not in supercritical zone definitely. So what we can do is go to table number 1. And at T is equal to 170 degree centigrade, we can get the values of HF and HG. So let us go to table number 1, look at T is equal to 170 degree centigrade and look at the values of HF and HG. So this is table 1, saturation line, base temperature. Let us go to T is equal to 170 degree centigrade. So here we are at 170 degree centigrade and this is table number 1, and correspond to that let us locate the value of enthalpies HF and HG, which are 719.08 and 2767.9. Alright, so this is the HF value and this is the HG value, and let us then try to compare the given H with these two values. Let us come back to the calculations. So we have got at T is equal to 170 degree centigrade, HF is equal to 719.08 kilojoule per kg and HG is equal to 2767.9 kilojoule per kg. And the given H value is 2821.5, which is more than HG. What does it mean? HG is nothing but saturated vapor line, and you are beyond that. It means that this region is superheated region, superheated vapor zone that we are in. Alright, so this is the answer. I will write this answer in our table now. So come to the fourth question, T is equal to 170 degree centigrade, H is equal to 2821.5, my answer is superheated vapor or superheated steam. Let us come to question number 5, where P is equal to 5 bar and V is equal to 0.0001 meter cube per kg. So again you got a one pressure or one temperature condition and other one is V that you have. What again would do? We will go for P is equal to 5 bar on table 2. Let us get the value of VF and VG and see and compare where this V lies as compared to VF and VG. So let us try to do this faster. Let us go to table number 2 directly and compare the value of V. So we say that 5 bar is 0.5 MPa. So we are at this point, and corresponding to this point, let us find out the value of V. So these are our VF and VG. All right. VF is 0.0010925 while VG is 0.37481, and let us compare our V value with this VF and VG. So let us come back to the calculations now. So P is equal to 5 bar and V is equal to 0.0001 meter cube per kg. As we went and saw, for P is equal to 5 bar or at 0.5 MPa, we had VF and VG, and we had VF is equal to 0.001009 and we had VG is equal to 0.37481, both meter cube per kg, meter cube per kg. And what you can see now, our V is less than Vf. Alright, so V is less than Vf, and therefore, where would we lie? If V is less than Vf, that means we are in subcooled region. Alright, we are the left side of the dome or left side of the LV line. So, therefore, we are in subcooled region. I am sure that you have understood this. Let us go back and write in the table. So, our last case is P is equal to 5 bar, V is equal to 0.0001 meter cube per kg. We say that we are in subcooled or compressed liquid region. Alright, so this is the way we have solved 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 problems. In the first two problems, pressure and temperature were given to us, and that is very simple. Depending on table 1 or table 2, whatever, we can come to the answer. Whether go for table 1 or table 2, we will come to the same conclusion. While in other three problems, we had got either pressure or temperatures, and one other property was given to us. So, depending on the comparison of this value with SF and SG, we can decide whether we are on LV line, wet region, inside the dome, superheated region, that is beyond SG value or beyond HG value, and subcooled region, that means less than VF value or SF value or HF value. Accordingly, we can classify different zones over here. Thank you very much.